Welcome back to The Lead. I'm Elizabeth Velasquez. Let's get started. In this episode, we're focusing on the significant role and impact of African Americans in Gainesville, the United States, and around the world. Chris Will and Charlene Metters have more in this edition of The Global Review.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to this edition of The Global Review. I'm Charlene Metters.
And I'm Chris Will. Here are some of the top stories from around the world.
There's a push for President Biden to name an African American as the next ambassador to China. Bryce Barros, an analyst with the German Marshall Fund, says appointing black ambassadors to America's adversaries will align with the U.S.'s advantage of diversity. The appointment of an African American ambassador to China would advance black representation in diplomatic positions. It would also advance conversations with U.S. allies on diversity in the foreign services.
For hundreds of African migrants, the path to freedom and prosperity now runs through the Americas. For many years, migrants from African countries like Sudan and Libya focused on moving to Europe to escape political unrest. Now the attention has shifted to the United States. This path starts with their arrival in Brazil. From there, migrants make their way through Peru and Ecuador before arriving in Colombia, where they then go through Panama and Central America before reaching the United States. The journey isn't a safe one, but the migrants feel the risks are worth it. This shift in immigration pattern serves as a potential change in the global landscape and a possible growth of U.S. immigrants from Africa.
China welcomed the Lunar New Year last Friday, February 12th. Some of the celebrations included festivities with dancers in blackface portraying Africans. The Chinese dancers were in African-style costumes and dark face makeup beating drums. China's ruling Communist Party tries to promote an image of unity with African nations as fellow developing economies. Black Liberty China, a group for people of African descent who work in China, said the broadcast was extremely disappointing. The group said these scenes had a huge negative impact on African communities who live in China.
Last week saw the first step in a historic nomination for the U.S. government. President Joe Biden nominated Shaquita Brooks Lashur to be the first black woman to head the Center for Medicare and Medicaid Services. If confirmed, Brooks Lashur would have oversight on Medicare, Medicaid, Children's Health Insurance, and the Affordable Care Act. This is among many firsts for the Biden administration that has already seen the first female Treasury Secretary, first openly gay cabinet member, and first black Pentagon chief. All a part of Biden's mission to make the cabinet, quote, more representative of the American people.
With Black History Month coming to an end, it's important to note that many still believe there is major work left to be done. A recent Global News poll in Canada found 54% of respondents believe racism is built into their economy, government, and educational systems. The survey showed that sentiment is strongest from those between 18 and 54 years of age at 57%, but those above age 55 are most likely to say schools do not teach black history effectively, coming in at 61%. Most notably, two out of every three respondents said they agree with the statement that police treat black people less fairly than white people throughout the country. That's it for this week's edition of The Global Review. I'm Charlene Metters.
And I'm Chris Will. See you next time.
The United States Congress has introduced a bill that looks into reparations for African Americans. Let's dive into the Politic Corner to find out more. The bill proposes the creation of a federal commission to study the effects of slavery and its impact on society. The commission would also develop solutions to help African Americans in the economic, educational, and health sectors. The bill was named H.R. 40, referring to the 40 acres and a mule that were promised but never given to slaves. President Joe Biden and Vice President Kamala Harris have expressed their support for the bill and reparative justice in the past. However, there are no comments yet on whether it will be signed. It is Black History Month, and what better way to commemorate it than by honoring black leaders who left an impact on the University of Florida. UF's first black law student was George Stark Jr. He was a civil rights trailblazer and attended the UF Law School in 1958. In 1962, Stark Jr. became the first African American to be employed as an investment advisory aide at Moody's Investment Advisory Services in New York City. In 2009, he was awarded the University of Florida's Distinguished Alumni Award. And in 1998 and 2018, the UF's Law Center for the Study of Race and Race Relations recognized Stark Jr.'s efforts in the community and nation. He served on the UF Alumni Association Board of Directors and the UF Foundation's DC Council. Stark Jr. continues giving back to the Gator community and is a member of UF's Alumni Association, Kappa Alpha Psi Fraternity, and Florida Blue Key. Another influential black leader who left behind her legacy at the University of Florida is Professor Patricia Hillier Nunn. Professor Hillier Nunn passed away on August 5th, 2020, at 57 years old. She was an adjunct African American Studies professor at UF. However, her influence still lives on. The Gainesville community remembers Hilliard Nunn for her empowerment and for her role in uncovering racism in Alachua County. She was not only an educator, but also a poet, activist, and a member of Delta Sigma Theta. The city of Gainesville continues hosting events to celebrate Black History Month. Gainesville Live is a concert series that honors Black History Month. Due to the COVID-19 pandemic, the concerts are virtual this year. The three concert series began with its first show on February 12th. Proceeding with his second show on February 19, and will conclude with his final show on February 26. The featured Black artist for the show on Friday is jazz vocalist and UF student DCO McDuffie. The performance will be streamed for free through Facebook on the Free Fridays page and McDuffie's page. The Gator Wesley Foundation is honoring Black History Month with movie nights. The film event began on February 5th, showcasing the movie Soul. The event continued with a second movie night on February 19th, playing the movie Get Out, and will finalize with its last movie night on February 26th. The movie Hidden Figures will be played starting at 7 p.m. on Friday. To find out more details on the movie night, visit the Gator Wesley Foundation page on Facebook. And lastly, the musical Aretha, Queen of Soul, is coming back to town on Friday, February 26th. The musical is based on the life of Aretha Franklin, telling the story of her personal life and professional career. The event will take place at the Star Theater from Friday, February 26th to Sunday, February 28th, with one session from 8 p.m. to 10 p.m. each day. The tickets are $22 for adults, $20 for seniors, and $15 for students. For more details, visit starcenter.ticketleap.com. That's it for this episode of The Lead. Make sure to follow us at WUFT News on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube. I'm Elizabeth Velasquez. Thanks for watching.